We get tanning because our outer layer of the skin has got a lot of melanin in it. Now, melanin is basically your skin's barrier or skin's way to protect the skin from UV damage. So whenever there's a lot of UV radiation or when there's a lot of, you're under direct sun, that is when our skin produces more melanocytes, which produce more melanin. So basically, it's an effort to protect your skin. For us Indians, we are many, many, many shades, or as the hype nowadays is skin of color. But we Indians have a lot of shades of brown, right? There's also the fairer spectrum and there's also the light brown spectrum as well. But basically, this is how skin tans. If you can see over here, different shades of skin tan very differently. But for protection, there are a few things you can do to first prevent skin tanning. The number one thing is, of course, is to not be out in the sun if you can help it. And if you have to be out, then make sure the face is protected or the body part is protected. Like if I'm going to go out like this in the sun, I'm going to have like a line at the end of the day. For sure, I tan really, really fast. And so clothing is one option. The second option is to always use sunscreen. Sunscreen helps prevent the UV radiation. It helps prevent the radiation from burning up our skin. Once the prevention is over, now what can you do to make your skin stronger to not get tanned in the first place? The most important thing is to help your skin build collagen. The more stronger collagen you have, the stronger collagen layer you have, the less damage your skin will have when you're out in UV radiation. There'll be less wrinkling, and also, you know, have use ingredients that actually fight the free radicals which come because of sun's heat or because of the pollution around us. The number one product that helps us do that is vitamin C. So introduce vitamin C into your skincare as early as possible. Along with vitamin C, that is topically, also start having vitamin C tablets. It's really, really good because it builds your body from the inside out to prevent oxidative stress. Oxidative stress is what really ages our skin very fast. So do that. A lot of citrus juices are also great for you. The second most important product to prevent suntan and also to heal from a suntan is a moisturizer. Because moisturizers have the most important function that your skin needs help with. They've got humectants, which are able to get water from the environment and lock it into your skin. Then they have the, the occlusives. Occlusives are able to make sure that this water remains trapped in your skin, doesn't get released from the skin, or basically trans-epidermal loss of water doesn't happen. And the third thing they'll have is emollient. Emollient kind of smoothen out the skin and give you a nice texture, right? All of these three things are required for your skin to fight suntan. Why? Because the more hydrated your skin cell is, the less burnt it's going to get. The stronger it's able to fight scarring or pigmentation. It also gives your skin a nice radiance because, you know, it's full of water, it's hydrated, it's plop plop nicely, right? It's not dried and shriveled up. So make sure you're using a good moisturizer. I have a video on moisturizers. Make sure you have a look at it. Now, once with all of this, you do develop a tan. Here is what is important for you to know. What has happened is all the skin's response of saving it from the sun's radiation has caused a lot of melanin deposit on your skin, right? So it is going to be a cycle of these old skin cells being sloughed off or removed from your skin and the fresher, younger cells coming to your skin. Now, if your skin is healthy, it's, you know, plump, it's well taken care of, it's got good nutrition, your skin cell turnover is going to be very healthy. So you'll see a change between 25 to 30 days. There are lakhs of YouTube videos which will show you the tan going away in a day, in 2 days, in a week. That is one, bullshit, and secondly, not recommended, because anything that you're going to use that will take away the tan that fast is going to have a bleaching agent, which you don't want on your skin, because remember, your skin is damaged right now. If you're going to irritate it further, it will produce more pigment, it's going to get more pigmented, and that can actually lead to your melanocytes behaving in an unbalanced manner and can actually lead to melasma, can lead to the first reason for melasma. Melasma, one of the leading reasons is sun damage or UV radiation, right? So be very mindful of what you're going to use. My personal favorite face pack that I use during summers, because I do go out a lot and I do, tan very easily, is a video I did months and months back. It's a video on one of my favorite face packs. It's got capsaicin, which is red bell peppers. Red bell peppers are packed with vitamin C. So you need that, you know, collagen on your skin. You require that gentle feeding on your skin. do have a look at this particular video. It's a really good face pack. It's one of my most favorite face packs. I don't advise Upton at this time because, you know, you don't want any extra stress happening on your skin, don't want any extra rubbing on your skin, especially Uptons can have little bit of, you know, tiny dal or one of the masalas jo finely ground nahi hoga. You don't want that. Instead of that, use chemical exfoliation, gentle chemical exfoliations. The one from Deconstruct is really nice. I've been using that, testing it actually for the last few weeks, and I'm really, really loving it. Use it, it's beautiful. Use it in the night. Don't overuse it. Use it maybe twice a week to begin with, but make sure you have 3 to 4 days in between. You could also use an AHS sleeping mask. Look, gentle exfoliators. The Dot & Key sleeping mask is very good. You could also use exfoliator from the Minimalist if you like it. I prefer the exfoliator from the Deconstruct. It has better hydration, and that's what you require during this time. Introduce alpha-butin into your skin. Now, alpha-butin, azelaic acid, glycolic acid are all skin lighteners. I'm using the alpha-butin from The Ordinary. You could add alpha-butin from The Minimalist if you like. I've done a video on comparing those two. You could also add niacinamide from The Minimalist. Niacinamide again works on tyrosinase to prevent melanin action. All of these help. Azelaic works beautifully in fading your skin and lightening your skin. I am crushing on the azelaic from the Deconstruct. I've again done a video on it. It's just the most beautiful serum. You could try this. You could also add glycolic acid to your skincare. Glycolic acid is completely safe for brown skin, guys. If you're using any of these, you anyway need to be careful about the sun. So glycolic acid will give you a good amount of response in terms of fading the skin and making it lighter. Make sure you get the sunscreen, make sure you have vitamin C on, and you have your skin lightening game on. And when we start using all of these to lighten the tan or to heal the tan, it's important to be very aware that during this time, our skin requires even more protection from the UV light and the sun's radiation. So it's very, very important to limit your exposure, direct exposure to the sun as well. Now, if you're already using all of these in your skincare, which I know most of you do, what do you do? Well, when you are using all of these and you know you're going to be out for some time, you're going to be out in the sun, say you're planning a beach holiday or you have some events happening where you're going to be out in the sun for a few days continuously, it's very advisable to stop all of these, the AHAs, the glycolic, the exfoliating mask, the retinoids, at least 7 to 8 days before the event. This will help your skin not be as sensitive to UV damage as it would be when you were actually using these products. Every time a skin gets tanned, there is a fair amount of aging that takes place in the skin. You may not see the wrinkles today, you may not see the sun damage today, but sun damage is something that happens very slowly under the level of the skin. So just prevent it. You know, wear the whole mask, which we see a lot of young girls wear on scooters, very, very advisable, because that dupatta on your face for some time just gives you years and years of great skin and years of less sun damage. So, prevention and protection. I'm going to meet you in the comment section.